One of the most dangerous volcanoes in the Philippines is definitely erupting once again, and as a result, approximately 3,000 people have just been evacuated. What I'm referring to is the Mayon stratovolcano located on the far southeast portion of the island of Luzon, 14 kilometers northwest of Legazpi City. While Mayon had been debatedly erupting since December 8, 2025, activity transitioned from a weak effusive phase to a more potentially dangerous phase on January 6. How do we know this? Well, on that date, a superheated cloud of gas and rock escaped from Mayon's summit due to a rockfall caused by the growing lava dome and subsequently raced downslope at an estimated speed of 40 miles per hour or 64 kilometers per hour. Pyroclastic flows are generally lethal to anything they touch due to reaching temperatures of 200 to 700 degrees Celsius and outrun anyone, and apart from lahars, are Mayon's main overall eruptive hazard. Thankfully, the five pyroclastic flows which occurred on the 6th did not travel any further than a kilometer downslope, not harming anyone. However, with the potential for an eventual escalation to occur, the negative combination of potential upcoming heavy rainfall interacting with the volcano, and the unpredictability of volcanoes as a whole, Mayon's alert level was raised from 2 to 3. This occurred only 5 days after its alert level was raised from 1 to 2. All 3,000 evacuated people lived within its active 6-kilometer exclusion zone, and there is always the potential for the exclusion zone to be expanded further if eruptive activity increases. In other words, in my opinion, I am not saying that standing 1 meter outside the current exclusion zone edge is completely safe. It isn't. Sometimes volcanoes can be unpredictable and unexpectedly produce a far larger eruption than expected without much warning, such as seen during 1993. That eruption resulted in 77 fatalities, with the pyroclastic surges reaching just beyond a 6-kilometer radius in specific spots. While there is no indication I'm aware of suggesting a repeat event, I thought this is worth mentioning. Currently, presumed viscous basaltic andesite lava is erupting at Mayon's summit, expanding the lava dome present. When sections of this dome become too steep, they collapse, creating lava avalanches of hot blocks, pyroclastic flows, or a combination of both. While current eruptive activity for all intents and purposes is still fairly effusive and weak, there is a potential upcoming problem. You see, Mayon in particular has a habit of its edifice, or at least its magma conduit, directly interacting with heavy rainfall events. Whenever these occur and the volcano is erupting or was recently erupting, within a few hours to today's time, the number of volcanic earthquakes or volcanic explosions often increases. A potential issue is related to a chance of a low-pressure system which could reach up to the equivalent of tropical depression or tropical storm strength might hit the region sometime in the next 10 days. Rainwater can seep into the volcano's magma conduit despite its temperature, build in volume, and then flush to steam. Since steam takes up far more volume than the water it once was, it causes an immense amount of pressure to build. Thus, this can end in some form of volcanic explosion or partial dome collapse, which could even be quite large like seen at Semeru due to rainfall in late 2021, 2022, and 2025. With that being said, most eruptions of Mayon are still quite small and do not harm anyone, with two-thirds of historical eruptions rating on the Volcanic Explosivity Index as either a 1 or a 2. The ongoing eruption could last anywhere in the range of days to months, so there is the potential for those evacuated individuals to remain away from their homes for a decent length of time. Stay tuned for more updates. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Joshua Bell, for supporting my work.